the entrusted power or the ability for us to make wealth and to gather wealth. And so, if you have problems regarding your finances, that means to say that your finances are tried and you have some sort of difficulty, some sort of inability, let us just look at the Word of God and let us believe in what the Lord has to say. For this is a wonderful, powerful truth that the Lord has written in the Bible. And it says in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18, and it reads, "And you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is He who gives you power to get wealth, so that He may establish His covenant which He swore to your fathers, as it is this day. It is the Lord your God who gives you the power to get wealth." And I'd like also to compare with this verse of what is written in the Message Bible, the same verse, Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18. It says, "Well, think again. Remember that God, your God, gave you the strength to produce all this wealth so as to confirm the covenant that He promised to your ancestors as it is today." And if I would just connect this to what the Apostle Paul has to say, "Now in Jesus Christ there is neither Jew nor Greek, for those who have faith in the Lord are considered children of God, those who believe in Him just the way Abraham believes in God." And shall we pray? And let us ask the Lord for His divine intervention. And let us believe in our hearts that even in the midst of our financial difficulties, the Lord can give us fresh ideas, mighty and powerful ideas for us to be able to craft several steps or principles to follow through in order for us to be able to come up with good and better solutions, and that the Lord will also provide anything that He can provide for us to be uplifted, for us to be led to recovery financially. Because finances are being tried by so many aspects like sickness, accidents, or loss of job, loss of opportunity, or losing your business and business bankruptcy, or somebody had stolen your property or had forcibly taken what's yours, or the loss of a loved one, fire, flood, catastrophe, and every devastating incident in life. This particularly can erode our finances. But basically, by faith, we can believe in the Lord. For what He says, He is the giver of the power or ability or authority or even strength for us to produce wealth, because He has promised those who believe in Him. In verse 19, "Then it shall be, if you by any means forget the Lord your God and follow other gods and serve them and worship them, I testify against you this day that you shall surely perish." Those people who rejected the Word of God and His ways shall perish. But how about the children of God who loves the Lord so dearly. All right? In Proverbs chapter 10 verse 22 it says, "For the blessing of the Lord makes one rich, and he adds no sorrow with it." What are the things that had happened and now we are tried financially? Shall we bow our heads? Let's pray. Our gracious, loving Father, we thank you that even in the midst of trials, even in the needs, in the midst of needs, here you are speaking to our hearts. We should remember you. You have spoken to our hearts that we should remember you. Father, we humble before your presence and we ask you today, teach us and allow us to be able to open up our minds so that we can clearly see and understand the ways that you are teaching us. And so, Father, allow us to walk on the right path, leading to right decisions. And so, we can also land into that right destiny. You are God, our Father, and you're the one who said, we must remember you, because you have already given us the ability now, Lord. We ask you for wisdom and the discernment so that we can utilize this ability in a moral, righteous, and godly way. Father, let flow the fresh ideas, Lord God, and we receive it. Mark 11:24, whatever thing that we might ask in prayer by faith in the name of Jesus, we should believe that we have already received it, then it shall be given to us. Thank you so much. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. So good morning, everybody. It's 4:08 and 39 seconds, Manila time. Wow. It is opened up by saying, and you shall remember. You shall remember. The word remember is an antidote of forgetfulness. It's an antidote of being sidetracked, antidote for being out-focused. Remember means merong naunang isang makapangyarihang bagay o salita o pangako na dapat continually, consistently ay ino-observe, isinasabuhay, o kaya ginagawang pattern, guideline of our daily operations in this life. But somewhere, somehow, to forget what the Lord had said beforehand, that's the pretty challenge. Then, people as we are, we tend to do things our own way. And being lost and being troubled by so much depressing incidents and repercussions, results of those doing things out of our own way, nanganak ng nanganak ng mga troubles, nanganak ng nanganak ng maraming pangangailangan. And then in that particular moment, kapag pakiramdam natin parang lubog na tayo, baon na tayo, doon tayo magsusumikap, gumawa ng iniisip nating survival na mga hakbang. Not knowing na yung mga iniisip nating survival remedy, so to speak, bahala na kung anong maging resulta, ito pa yung magdadagdag ng maraming kabigatan. On the other hand, meron namang mga pagkakataon na we have already plotted a wonderful strategy on how for us to be able to receive good future, and everything is well, all is well, and then suddenly, boom, may nangyaring sakuna, may nangyaring unfavorable na mga bagay, marahil may nagkasakit sa pamilya, nagamit ang lahat, nagasta ang lahat, or merong isang minamahal na napahamak, na aksidente, and God forbid, hindi na makapagtrabaho. So lahat ng mga insurance, lahat ng mga naipon, savings ay nagamit na financially. O kaya somebody had gone waywardly, naging dependent ng mga illegal substances or naging alcoholic, naging biktima ng kanyang sariling vices, napahamak, nahuli, nakulong, nagkaroon ng verdict. Ito yung mga financial suckers. Ito yung mga financial, what we call that, parang mga kumunoy ng buhay. So, ang mga bagay na ito ay nadaragdagan ng mga kabigatan, lalo kung kuminsan, simple lang mismanagement. Mas malaki yung expenses palagi, every time, hindi napapansin, kaysa doon sa savings. Maganda kung ang blessing nag-i-increase, ang savings ay nag-i-increase, at ang expenses ay nag-de-decrease. O kaya, tumataas ng konti ang mga expenses, eh matindi naman, remarkably naman, na tumataas yung income, yung earning. Okay lang yan. At isa pang maganda, kung halimbawa ay magandang earnings at nakapagtatabi, sa Tagalog terminology, nakapagsusubi, nakapagsisiksik, nakapagsisave, and then later on, yung savings na yon ay mailalagay sa mga investments, at yung mga investments na yon ay nagiging assets, hindi liabilities. Meron ka ng income, ang spouse mo may income, anak mo may income, lahat kayo may income, tapos yung inyong savings, umi-income din, alright? So this is now entering into your savings, your money is now beginning to earn money for you. It is making your money to work for you. Yun yung mga ideas, yun yung mga pamamaraan, yun yung mga ilan sa mga general terms on how God has given us the ability or the strength to produce wealth. When it comes to strength, it goes without saying na yung health natin, yung kalusugan, kalakasan, yung you can wake up every morning strong and healthy, physically fit, mentally fit, emotionally stable, psychologically amazing and wonderful, you are ready to face another challenges, whether big or small, in your work or in your business, and you're always ready with all excitement to face that day, triumphant and with faith in the Lord, that's strength. And then you can brainstorm yourself and you can stretch yourself to work more hours to earn more for your future and for the future of your family. That's strength. At ang strength, basically, ang buhay ay galing sa Panginoon. We breathe ng hangin na walang measurement. Hindi siya per kilo, hindi siya binibenta. Meron tayong hininga na libre, meron tayong sunlight, liwanag ng araw na libre. Meron tayong opportunity to think and imagine and to dream and to set goals and to create visions. Libre po yon. So yun yung strength, yun yung power, yun yung ability that God is giving to each of us. So what is the most important thing to do? Number one, use that power, use that ability, use that according to God's way. Using our thinking faculty to dream, to visualize, to plan, to strategize, to write down every step of the way that the Lord is telling us to do in order for us to make good of this life. Making good of this life. For the Bible says, lalo na sa Ephesians chapter 2, tayo ay nilikha ng Panginoon at in-empower niya tayo sa 3 and 4, sapagkat tayo workmanship ng Panginoon, prepared and equipped for good works. Good works. Whether you are an employee to any government satellite office or head office or branch of office, or in a public company or corporation, or you are a businessman and you are an entrepreneur, whatever you do, you are a farmer, you are a driver, you know what? Natutuwa po ako sa mga Filipino na ngayon ay nalaman ko ultimo guards. Yung kalang minimum na sweldo. Yung marami, nagkakapag-complain sila kasi sabi nila, mas maraming oras ng trabaho, hindi naman paid yung overtime. Pero yung iba, tahimik lang, excited, lalo yung mga nagtatrabaho sa bangko, na mga security guards, natutuwa ako, meron akong kinausap. Sabi ko, Mr. Guard, I am a minister, I am a pastor. Matanong kita. Una, tanong ko para makapasok ako sa kanilang trust and confidence para ako ay harapin, makipag-usap saglit. Saan ka ba nagre-renew ng iyong security license for you to function as a security guard, licensed and authorized, especially to carry firearm? Sabi niya, sa head office po sir, sa Campo Crame. So sabi ko, oh, yeah, I know. Kasi, nandoon ako nung nagkaroon ng inauguration ng one-stop shop. Kasama ko yung chief PNP at marami pang mga advisors ng PNP, national at saka mga regional. Nandoon kami, na departmental. Sabi ko, nasa CSG ang aking affiliation para maging advisory council. E sabi niya, sumaludo siya, sabi niya, sir, magandang araw po. Sabi niya nun, sino po ba sila? Ano po bang pangalan nila? Sasabihin ko yung pangalan ko. Then sabi ko, meron kayong UITF dito sa bangko, yung trust fund. At yung savings na yan, merong magandang return. Ikaw ba ay nag-iipon din? Opo, sir. May hinuhulugan din po ako dyan. Sabi ko sa kanya, maganda yung may hinuhulog, dadating ang panahon, meron kang kukubrahin. Tumawa siya. Sabi niya, sana nga, sir. Sabi ko, you believe in the Lord. It shall happen. Halos ganyan. Pagka pumupunta tayo sa mga establishmento at merong guard, meron namang iba, tatrabaho saan man, sa mall or sa ibang mga detachments and establishments, at sasabihin, mahirap sir, kulang na kulang sir, ang sweldo namin, hindi kami binabayaran ng ganito, puro kami trabaho. You see, it's a mindset. How and what you're thinking about yourself. Pero meron hong paraan. God blesses us with the ability. Number one, gamitin natin yung ability na yan. Ask the Lord for us to be able to continue to cultivate that ability that comes from Him. Basically, siya naman ang nag-create ng utak, siya naman naglagay nito sa ating mga ulo para gamitin at mag-function. Better yet, use it, utilize it, allow that brain to function according to God's ways and will. Utilizing the power. Number two, relying on the power giver. Ayan, utilizing that power. Now, ngayon naman, relying. Okay? Relying. Ipagkatiwala natin sa Panginoon. Habang nagpaplano tayo, sabing ganun ang banal na kasulatan, nasa sa tao ang pagpaplano, pero nasa sa kapangyarihan ng Diyos ang pagpapaganap at pagpapatupad nito. At isang bahagi naman, banal na kasulatan, ang sabi doon, napakaraming sinusundan ng mga taong landasin. Akala nila, sa dulo nito ay mapapabuti sila. Yun pala, napapahamak sila. Well, kapag hindi tayo sumusunod sa Panginoon, there is a way that seems to be right, but at the end, it's destruction. Yun ho ang problema pag hindi tayo nagre-rely. Kaya sabi ng banal na kasulatan, trust in the Lord with all of your heart and do not lean to your own understanding. In everything, acknowledge the Lord, then He will guide us through a straight path. Alright? Salamat sa Diyos. Opo. Ikatatlo, realizing that you are a child of God. Yung word na realizing ay marami pong ibig sabihin. Ibig sabihin, number one, letter A. Number three, letter A. Realizing means tuklasin mo na. Parang discovering din, para ma-realize mo yung ano yung nakatagong gintong aralin para po sa atin. Okay? Upang gumanda yung ating kinabukasan. Three, letter B. Yung realizing na yun ay makamtan mo na at mapanghawakan mo ng mabuti. Okay? Withholding the promise or the promises of God. Through the power, the equipping power, the authorizing power that gives us the strength and the ability for us to be able to produce more wealth. Alright? A godly wealth. Accumulate godly wealth to be used in a godly way so that that wealth will continue to produce more godly rewards. Godly rewards. Hindi nasasayang, hindi nawawala, hindi nananakaw. Alright? Meron mga panahon na parang twisted ang mga pangyayari compared with what we believe in. Pero anong ninakaw ng kaaway, sabi ng banal na kasulatan, ibabalik ng Panginoon ang siksik, liglig at nag-uumapaw. Lalo kung ito ay ginagawa mo purposely para sa kaluwalhatian ng Panginoon, hindi mo mawawala. Parang dumaan lang at pagbalik nito ay merong godly rewards. Where in fact, yung hindi godly way ay merong hindi godly rewards. Yung tinatawag na natural consequence. Pag naglaro ng apoy, talagang nasusunog, napapasok, napapahamak. Okay? Parang fire. Yung fire, nagagamit yan sa pinakamagandang benepisyo. Yung fire can also give light. The fire can give light. The fire can give guidance. Fire can give protection. And even can cook meals. Fire can sanitize. Fire can, you know, reform by deforming what has been formed before. Plastic, bakal, ginto, silver, nickel, copper, bronze, wood, nakakapag-transform, nakapag-recreate ang fire. Sanctifier ang fire. Nasa-sanctify, nagpo-purify. Pero pag mishandled, nakakawasak ng buhay, nakakasunog ng ari-arian, nakakatupok ng bahay, ng boat o ng barko o ng bus. Kagaya last week, mayroon isang bus na natupok, nasunog sa harapan mismo ng SM Mega Mall dyan sa may Mandaluyong City. It can devastate, it can destroy, it can really be very, very destructive kapag mishandled. Marirealize natin. Ikatlong realization, yung ma-enjoy mo kung ano ang value nito, kung ano ang purpose nito, bakit binigay ito ng Panginoon. Alright? So, napakaganda po ng atin pong pinag-usapan ngayon. And you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is He, the Lord our God, who gives you the power to get wealth. At ang sabi sa The Message Bible, well, think again. Remember. Think again. Remember that God, your God, twice niya sinabi, just to emphasize more. Remember that God, your God, very personal na, ano? Possessive na ang pagiging declaration itong The Message Bible. Sabi, remember that God, no, parang general pa nung una, your God, possessive, personal, propositioning, okay? Propositioning. You gave you the strength to produce all this wealth. All this wealth. Kaya pala, sabi ng Panginoong Jesus, but you seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you, as well. Oh, Matthew 6:33, unto you as well. Seek first the kingdom of God, but seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all of these things shall be added unto you as well. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. For He is able to do exceedingly abundantly beyond what we could ever think or imagine. Can do exceedingly abundantly beyond what could we ever think or imagine, according to the power. All right, according to the power that He had set in motion, meaning in operation, inside of us. So number one, utilize that power. That is the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Number two, reliance to that power. Utilization, reliance to that power. Utilize that power, rely upon that power, and then realize that power. Realize that power. And when God's power begin and continues to produce good things upon your life, you will also begin to remember and to recount. Remembering and recounting. Sinasabi natin, sinasabuhay natin, ang katotohanan, ang Diyos nga, ang ating Ama sa Langit, ang nagkakaloob sa atin ng kakayahan na sumagana upang magiging kasangkapan niya sa kanyang layuning i-evangelize ang buong sanlibutan. Friends, thank you for watching for this live broadcast through Facebook Live. And please, hit that button, like. And then, you also share our videos to your loved ones, to your friends, especially those whom you know that are really struggling hard in their life. And by doing that, you're not only doing what God wants you to do, but you are doing great favor to somebody. And next, you are doing good favor to yourself. Sapagat we are built, we are designed, we are purposed by God to do every good work. And if you are doing good work every time, you will also receive godly rewards from the Lord. Our God is a God of rewards. He knows how to reward His children, those who are consistently observing and doing what they have heard from the Lord. Friends, to God be the glory. If someone of you is suffering from sickness, or someone from your family is sick, or you've been tried by so many kinds of trials, it is my personal prayer, it is our advocacy, okay, that each of us will come to know in a very personal manner how powerful and how mighty God is, our Father in heaven. And because of the Lord Jesus Christ, we can surely avail of His divine intervention, His help. Because the Bible also says, and the eye of the Lord is upon the righteous, meaning He intentionally searches us. Not because He cannot find us, but meaning He is scrutinizing with His holy and righteous eyes, observing our life every moment to see if we are doing what He says. Because His rewards are always ready and available for you. God bless you. Shalom. Shall we bow our heads? Let us pray. Father, may You continue to bless the Philippines as You also bless our brethren coming from many different parts of the four quadrants of the world. And we thank You for making us able to communicate with one another almost seamlessly because of this advent of internet and online communication. Lord, pagpalain mo nga po sila, anuman po yung kalang mga kabigatan, anuman po yung kalang mga pasan-pasan sa oras na ito, yung mga struggles and trials ng Panginoon, allow them to see and realize that You are with them, that Your hand of power is with them, that Your empowerment is right in their hearts. In Jesus' name. Sino mang may sakit at karamdaman, ingatan mo at pagpalain, Panginoon. Yung sobra ng nahihirapan sa kalang kalalagayan, Lord, let Your will be done. Let Your healing power, whether physical or spiritual, manifest in Jesus' name. Because for each of us who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, death has no more power against us. Because even in our life after death, there is the tremendous joy, incomparable joy and state waiting. Let Your name be glorified upon its healing. Let Your name be glorified upon its blessing. Let Your name be glorified upon its moment of homecoming. Father, thank You for heaven, thank You for salvation, and thank You for Your way of salvation, Jesus Christ, Your Son, now our Lord and Savior. And thank You for Your sanctification, the grace that sanctifies us, the Holy Spirit who lives with us. Father, bless the Philippines and bless the whole world with Your word and by Your children here. In Jesus' name, amen. Good day, Italy. Ma'am Chidora Benito Pisek, good morning. Mikey and Sisa, good morning. Fe Aquino, good morning. Ate Liwanag Linang, good morning. Doctora Ilia Tejada, good morning. Good morning, everybody. Thank you for watching. And continue to follow us Facebook Live and also in our YouTube channel, The Day of Hope in Jesus Christ Live. At makikita ninyo yung iba't ibang mga titles na ating video naka-upload doon. Sister Tess Lee, good morning. Hallelujah. God bless you everybody and regards. See you again tonight, 10 o'clock in the evening. Bye for now.